Hey everyone, I'm Samyak Agarkar and welcome to Agarkar Media Academy. This is the fourth tutorial in Blender 2.81 tutorial series. So in the last tutorial, we saw adding and deleting objects inside of Blender. So in this tutorial, we are going to move forward with more functionalities inside of Blender. So let's add an object. So for adding an object, we saw the shortcut is Shift A. Of course, I don't know why it is not showing up on this side, but basically right now I'm pressing Shift and A. So Shift A, let's add a cube. Now what we want to do is it will not be the case that every time every object should be at the center, right? So if you look at this, you have a red line, a green line and an imaginary blue line going upwards. You can see the same right here. The red line is the x-axis. If you have knowledge about how 3D works, there are basically three perpendicular lines which are called axes, x, y and z. So these are the three dimensions that we work with in 3D, x, y, z or z. So the red one is the x direction, x-axis, y is the y direction or y-axis, and z is the z direction or z axis. So right now here you cannot see the blue line, but soon you will be able to see the blue lines when we start working with the transformations, right? So now there will be cases when you want to move the object in the viewport itself. For now we just saw panning, but the panning is not moving the objects in the space. So let's see if we want to add a new object. Let's say a circle is not a good example here. Let's add a cone. Now here you can see there is a cone, but both of them are intersecting, they are one inside another, right? The cone is inside the cube. Now of course you don't want that to happen, you want to move the object, right? So you're just going to undo. Control Z is for undo. So we want to move the object, right? Now moving, or there are other stuff also, these are called as transformations. So basic three transformations are available in Blender: move, rotate and scale. Now where you can see those things here: move, rotate and scale, and this one is the transform which gives all of them. Move, rotate and scale. Let's look at it. I'm right here. First of all, we have to select the object. We'll select the cube. Left click on the cube, select the cube, move. Now as soon as I click move, first of all I was here, which was the select box. Now I go to move. Now you can see there are three arrows on this, right? The blue arrow, the green arrow and the red arrow. So if I just click and hold the blue arrow and I move my mouse, the cube will move in x direction, right? If I press the green arrow and I move my mouse, it will move in y direction only. And if I move the blue arrow and if I move the mouse, it will move only in the z direction. So I have to understand what we are basically doing is moving the object either in x, y or z, right? X, y, z, these are the three axes. Now of course here you can see these small boxes, right? So this is the blue box here, it's a square, right? A blue square here. So what does it do? Now what did blue do? Let's just pan. Panning is shift and middle mouse button. What did this blue do? Moving the object in z direction. Now what will this do? You can see it is just in between of the red and the green arrow. So what it does is move the object everywhere except in the z direction. So now if we move the object is being moved only in xy plane, on the xy plane. It is moving on the xy plane of the origin of the object, right? If we do it from the arrow, then it moves in the z direction. If we do it through this box, then everything except z, so it moves on the xy plane, right? The same goes for green. Green is opposite of, so green box is opposite of green arrow. So everything except y direction. So now we are moving in the xz plane, right? The same for red. Red is opposite of, red box is opposite of red arrow. So everything except x direction. So we are basically moving the object in zy plane or yz plane, right? So you should be understanding different, what it is called as 3D transformations. You should have some knowledge and you should be able to visualize it, right? The same goes for rotation. As soon as I click rotate, the gizmo, this is something called as gizmo. So for movement, we had arrows. For rotation, we have these circles. The same thing goes here also. If I just click and drag the red, the blue circle, then I can rotate it in the blue direction. You can see it right here, right? I am moving the circle in blue, the cube in on z axis. Blue is for z, right? On red, so I am rotating around the x axis, and green, I am rotating it around the y axis, right? So this is all about rotation. And the same goes for scaling. Now here you can again see the boxes. Now right here, now here are cubes. For move, there were arrows. Now for scale, it has these cubes. So if I press and hold and drag the blue button, then it will scale it in the z direction. You can see I am scaling the cube in the z direction. If I press the green box, then I am scaling it in the y direction. If I am the same, if I am doing it with the red box, it is scaling in the x direction. Again, we see these small squares here. The same functionality as it was in the move direction, tool. This blue square is scaling the object in every direction except the blue, that is except the z. So now I am scaling the object in x and y direction. I am not scaling it in the z direction. I am just scaling it in the x y direction. Same for red, everything except x. Now I am scaling it in y z direction, right? It's too confusing to talk about it, but yeah, you get the point, right? And the same goes for the green box. Now I am scaling it in only the x and z direction. It's difficult, but here you can see this length does not change, right? So you can understand that it is just scaling up in x and z direction, but not in the y direction. Now there's one more thing. If I just press it on the middle, I am on the scale tool. If I just press it on the middle and do it from the middle, let's just first decrease the size. Yeah, so if I do it from the middle, then I'm basically scaling it in every direction. It's difficult to understand right here, right? Is it possible? I don't know. Okay, cool. Anyways, now we will first again add shift A, add a cube on the here. Now we are going to look at, I'm just panning it, we are just going to look at the shortcuts for move, rotate and scale. Again, moving the mouse here takes time. For now you will think that, you know, pressing the buttons on keyboard is difficult because you have to remember the shortcuts and look at the keyboard and press the keys, press the shortcuts. But as soon as you get practice of using the shortcuts, it becomes much more easier than using these tools and these buttons right here. So for, again, we go to the selection mode, select box, we select the cube. Now movement, for some weird reason, is grabbing in shortcuts. So for move, the shortcut is not M, but the shortcut is G, because you basically grab the object and then move around. Grab the object and move around. I don't know if you can imagine this, but we are grabbing the object and moving it around and placing it somewhere. So G is the shortcut for moving. G. So now I am grabbing the object. I press G. You can see it right here. I am grabbing the object, and along with the mouse, I am not pressing any button right here, right? I just press G. Now it is snapped to the mouse, and wherever my mouse goes, the object moves. If I want to what is it called, let's say finalizing the location, then left click will finalize the position. G, move the mouse. I want to finalize it here. Left click. That's it. Now, there can be a chance that you grabbed it, but now you don't know the exact position where you grabbed it from. And you don't want to finalize it here. You want to go back to the same position. What you have to do is right click. Right click brings it back to the original position. So, G, move, left click brings it to the finalized position, and G, move, and right click brings it to the original position, right? Now for rotation, it's very simple, R, and we can rotate it here, right? We can rotate it here, good. And for scale is S, scale, right? You just have to move the mouse here and there and it scales, right? Now, but in these tools, we saw this snapping of direction, right? Z, X, Y directions. So how does it happen in with the shortcuts? So when I grab, so G, now I want to move only in the X direction. Let's say this one is the X direction. Then I just press X on the keyboard. Now it is, you can see the line passing through it, which is a parallel line to the X axis. Now I'm moving the object only in the X axis. Don't tell me that you this is not the parallel line. Of course, what the heck, this is not a parallel line. This is a parallel line, but we are in the perspective mode, right? Here you can see user perspective. So we are viewing the 3D viewport in perspective mode. We are not in the orthographic mode. So of course these two lines are parallel, believe me, these two lines are parallel, but just because it is in perspective mode, and I believe it is 1 point perspective mode, so everything goes to just one, you know, point. It just converges everything to one point. So at infinity, these two lines will converge somewhere on one point for this screen, just because we are in the perspective mode. But orthogonally, it is not. We'll see how to get to the orthogonal mode, view mode soon. So grab X and move in the X direction, grab Y, move it in the Y direction, grab Z, move it in the Z direction. The same goes for rotation. Let's just put it here. R, X, rotate it along the X axis. R, Y, rotate it along the Y axis. R, Z, rotate it along the Z axis. The same goes for scaling. S, X, scale it just in the Y, X direction. Scale Y, scale it in the Y direction. S, Z, scale it in the Z direction. Now, we saw when we were in the move mode, we saw these little squares which inverted the axis, right? Meaning, if I press blue button, then everything except blue, right? Everything except Z was being moved. So the same is possible here also. What we have to do is, let's just first add a cube. I don't want to see the transformed cube here. Good, this one. Now, what I'm doing, grab. Now, when I press X, I'm moving it in the X direction. But Shift X moves it in the X, Z, Y, Z direction. So, everything except X. Shift X is what I press. Shift X. Of course, it is showing X here, but believe me, I'm pressing Shift and X, right? Now the same, grab, Shift Y, then everything except the Y direction, and grab, Shift Z, then everything except the Z direction, right? Here you can see I'm just moving it in the XY plane. The same goes for rotation, right? But it basically makes no sense in rotation, but yeah, good. We can use it, rotation. So, right, basically when we do not Y, it's basically rotate it along the X and Z axis, which is again the Y axis itself. So it has no functionalities. Even in the rotation tool, we saw there is no functionality of except Y. So there is no inversion because it's the same. Scaling also has the same, S, shift X, then we are scaling it in the Y, Z axis, Y, Z direction and not X axis. Scale, shift Y, everything except Y, scale in everything except Y direction, and S, shift Z, scale it in every direction except the Z direction. So we saw different transformation tools. This was a longer video because these are the most basic functionalities that we'll be using in Blender, and every model, every object that you create in Blender will have to work with these three functionalities: scale, grab, and the movement, rotation, and scaling. These are called the transform. Just one last thing I think I missed. If I click the transform button, you can see all the three gizmos. So it has the arrows of move button, it has the circles of rotation, and it has the boxes of scaling. So the transform is just that. Mostly I would recommend don't use these tools, just go with the shortcuts. It's much more easier once you get you just remember all those shortcuts, and it just becomes easy. So sorry for the long video, it was a very long video, but yeah, we learned a lot in this video. So hope you guys this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you haven't yet subscribed to this YouTube channel, please do subscribe. Share this video with as many people as possible so that even more people can learn to use Blender and create awesome 3D animation in Blender. And of course, please spread this message. Please spread this video with as many people as possible. You are the guys who are going to support this channel. This channel is nothing without you, the viewers and the subscribers. So if you have watched this video till this point of time, thank you so much for watching the video. I hope you learned something from this video, and you'll be learning something from all the tutorials that I'm going to post on this channel. See you in the next video. Till then, keep smiling and keep learning.